This is not your regular rhythm-based game. In Drums Rock, by playing some drums, you will be fighting demons. Small demons, large demons, and truly gigantic ones, too. Friends, lots of rhythm-based games exist in VR. Since Beat Saber and Synth Riders, we've been getting a lot more, and I'm actually really excited about games that incorporate cool rock vibes, like Smash Drums and Unplugged VR, that actually give you a feeling like you're playing a musical instrument, which is pretty awesome. But this new game that I have tested recently managed to do something even cooler. In Drums Rock, you get to sit at a cool-looking color-coded drum set, smash to some awesome rock songs, and destroy these flying demons that will be coming right in your face. I got to test an early access version of this game, which will become available on SideQuest and App Lab by the end of this year, and for now, I wanted to share with you my impressions of Drums Rock, because this one feels very different from all other rhythm-based VR games I've played. Remember to give this video a like and subscribe to Disco VR to support this channel, and also don't forget to enter the Oculus Quest 2 giveaway by following the link in the description below. If you're ready, let's go! The rules of Drums Rock are very simple. Monsters of different colors will fly at you, and you gotta hit the drum of the same color as the monster at the exact moment when the two rings come into one, which will give you a perfect score. These beats are very well synchronized with the songs, so once you find the rhythm, it feels very satisfying. But I realized that I should have taken a better look at the colors of the drums, because during the game, it's almost impossible to look at both the incoming monsters and the drum colors, so it's best to quickly memorize them before the game, although it takes some practice. At first, my brain kept freezing as I would mix up the yellow and the red drums, but you're definitely getting better the more you practice. You can also charge your drumsticks by throwing them in the air and catching them, or by bouncing them off of your drum and catching it also in the air. But if you don't catch it and it falls, then you're risking of skipping the beat. But overall, it's really fun. I think it's fair to compare this game to Smash Drums, since both are rhythm-based drum games, but their mechanics are quite different. Smash Drums is a position-oriented game where you basically hit the drums as they are coming at you. You don't actually have a drum set in front of you, so it can be compared to the incoming blocks like in Beat Saber, making these two games fairly similar. But Smash Drums is a seated game that imitates your sitting in front of a drum set. All the drums are in a fixed position, and the position of the incoming demons doesn't matter, only their colors matter. So as soon as they reach the sweet spot and the two circles come together, you need to hit the drum of the same color as that monster. This really can mess up your orientation, because the demons can come from different directions. I find it tricky to keep myself in control and remind myself that I only should care about the colors of the monsters and not their position in the air. Because I would always hit the same drums in a fixed position, this game really made me feel like I was playing drums and not just hitting the air, which is super cool. I guess you could also compare this game to Ragnarok, another rhythm-based drum game, but it's a totally different set of drums. And this one is a lot more traditional-looking rhythm-based game, while with Smash Drums, you're literally killing demons by the power of the drum set. The early access version only had 3 songs in it, and I really loved how well drum beats were synchronized with the songs. It made it feel really awesome, because when you find the momentum and you catch the rhythm of the song, you really feel like you're playing drums, and it felt very satisfying. However, one thing I've noticed that made playing really difficult is that when monsters are coming at you really fast, they sort of cover each other, and you only get a few milliseconds to realize which color of the drum you're supposed to hit. So the game could do better at adjusting the angle from which the monsters are coming, so that players have enough time to prepare for what's coming next, instead of only when it's right in front of your face. This is especially noticeable at the medium and hard levels. I really enjoyed the easy levels, even though I still found them challenging at the beginning. I somehow managed to pass the medium levels, and that was really hard, but the difficult levels were almost unplayable for me, unless the goal is to memorize the songs and just know which drums to hit, which I don't think is a good idea for a game. Basically, I hope that the developers will be able to adjust the angles of the incoming monsters to make passing those hard levels a little bit more realistic, because as of now, at least for me, it's nearly impossible. I certainly enjoy the game most at the easy levels because it still took me some practice before I could ace the songs, and now I just enjoy playing it again and again because, well, I do well at them, and drumming to the beats of those cool songs is very satisfying. I'm really looking forward to seeing how this game is going to turn out on its release. So far, the date is not set in stone, but the developers promised that it will come out on the App Labs and SideQuest by the end of this year, so I'm really looking forward to it. Let me know in the comments if you like this type of games and whether you think that Drums Rock will be the game for you. Please remember to like this video and subscribe to DiscoVR to support the channel, and of course, enter the Oculus Quest 2 giveaway by following the link below. Thank you so much for watching, friends. Stay safe, and as always, happy gaming!